Presidential candidate Robert F. Kennedy Jr. is filing a lawsuit against both YouTube as well as its parent company Google, alleging that they have censored him. He cites multiple of his videos that have been removed from YouTube, and he specifically attacks YouTube's medical misinformation policies, saying that they are overbroad and vague. Now you might be wondering, how is he going to sue YouTube and Google for this, considering that they are, you know, they're private companies? There's no First Amendment right to have your videos on a private company's platform. Well, he says this. So he filed this 27-page complaint in California earlier this week. He says that those sites caved to pressure to, quote, silence him by the federal government and his Democratic primary rival, President Joe Biden. And he said, or the lawsuit says, under these circumstances, YouTube is a state actor and it violated Mr. Kennedy's First Amendment rights by engaging in viewpoint discrimination, specifically having to do with videos of him talking with Jordan Peterson or Joe Rogan or a speech that he gave in New Hampshire back in March. So the idea that because in his view they bowed to pressure that he says exists that makes them state actors definitely seems like an untested theory. So we have no idea how a court is gonna feel about that. But to give you an idea of some of what the sort of things that he said that's run afoul of these YouTube policies, take a look at this.
COVID-19 is targeted to attack Caucasians and black people. The people who are most immune are Ashkenazi Jews and Chinese. There's aluminum in those vaccines, which, you know, operates along the same biological pathways and does the same kind of damage. It's extremely neurotoxic. And then there's other things, lots of other toxics in the vaccines that, you know, could be responsible. I mean, there's hundreds and hundreds of scientific studies that looks at it, but nobody ever reports them. And unfortunately, the vaccines are not safety tested. They're not, of the 72 vaccine doses now mandated, essentially mandated, they're recommended, but they're really mandated for American children. None of them, not one, has ever been subject to a pre-licensing placebo-controlled trial.
Yes, they have.
Those studies have, the only medicine that never gets tested are vaccines. And that is what I object to.
So those are the sorts of claims that have gotten him in trouble with YouTube and Google. And it now occurs to me, might get this video pulled as well. But so you might want to give your reaction quickly because this video could be pulled at any second.
Yeah, look, YouTube is in a difficult situation, as is all of social media. Because on the one hand, if you overban stuff, you're gonna ban something like the lab leak theory, which is a perfectly valid theory. So you have to be careful and not just have a gut reaction of, oh, some Democrats said it in Washington, let's ban it. You can't do that, okay? On the other hand, what these right-wing knuckleheads, including JFK Jr., who was most definitively in the wrong primary, okay? All of his supporters are Republicans. Online, I've never seen a Democratic supporter of RFK Jr. The most zealot MAGA guys are like, RFK Jr., I love Democrats. Wait, what? Okay, no. Anyway, those are all lies. Sorry, Bobby, you don't know what you're talking about. Vaccines have never been tested. I mean, that's insanity, man. That's just insanity. So, and what? And he's like, oh, I didn't imply that the Jews did the vaccine. I just said the only ones that doesn't affect are the Chinese and the Ashkenazi Jews. I didn't imply anything. Come on, you don't know. You know all these Jewish folks. And you, yes, you're friends with Jewish people. I know. I know. You don't know that anti-Semitic trope? And you didn't know that you were implying that? At a bare minimum, that is massive negligence on your part. But guys, to the main point here, what if these kooks then came out with, because they don't believe any scientists. They said 99% of the world's scientists say climate change is real. They're like, oh, you're right. What would all the scientists in the world know? Let alone evolution. Like, there's no way they're gonna believe scientists on that, right? Of course the earth was created 6,000 years ago. Okay, and then now vaccines, like scientists would know anything about a vaccine. No, it's just totally untested, filled with aluminum pipes they're putting in there. Like, all right, so what if the new conspiracy theory against scientists and Republicans, you know you're on the right side of things when you've got a war against scientists. You know what a scientist is? All it is someone trying to figure out what's true. That's all a scientist is. Oh yeah, the people trying to figure out things that are true, hate them. Okay, what if the next conspiracy theory is, oh, you know, 99% of the world scientists think that gravity's real. It's not, man. It's not. Gravity's fake. That's a conspiracy theory. And they started telling people to walk off of rooftops. Like, I feel, I'm a little scared even putting it out into the world, because there's like some percentage chance Republicans are going to start to believe it. So is YouTube supposed to allow that? Where they are encouraging people to walk off of buildings because they think the scientists are lying about gravity? Because remember, a lot of these lunatics also believe that the earth is flat. They're going to fall off the earth. So yes, it's very difficult to know where to draw the line between, yeah, allow the lab leak theory because that's plausible, and do not allow them to lie brazenly about science or medicine, etc. So, but no, Bobby Kennedy Jr. doesn't do nuance now, doesn't do distinctions. And then he implies that Biden is behind this. Just when you thought like he can't go any lower, Biden told YouTube and Google to do this? Again, I'm not sure he's saying it, but he's definitely implying it heavily, like, oh, Biden's America, YouTube and Google. You think Biden's calling YouTube and Google to tell him, oh, make sure you get rid of Bobby Kennedy? Man, that's just cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs, Moz.
It gets nuttier and nuttier, like you're saying, Cenk. He basically, you got someone who is a conspiracy theorist who then turned to a conspiracy theory to bring the case. Because as John said at the beginning of this segment, you can't just sue the private company for taking you off. It's a private company, they do whatever they want. No shirt, no service, get the hell out of here. But in this case, they tied it to a government entity to say, look at the conspiracy, therefore you're stopping my First Amendment rights. So a conspiracy to fight the fact that you were putting conspiracies on their page. It's similar to what Sidney Powell did when she went to Donald Trump with the election conspiracy, where she said it was Venezuela and it was Iran and China in cahoots with the CIA to get him out. So all of a sudden, it just gets crazier and crazier. If John F. Kennedy, Robert Kennedy Jr. were not a Kennedy who was educated, he could be on a street corner ranting and we'd be like, oh, I'm so sorry, you know, I hope this guy gets some help. He is an intelligent person in terms of studying and his knowledge, and I've listened to him a few times, and it's amazing how when in his interviews they go, well, you said this, you don't believe in vaccines or you're a conspiracy theorist. He goes, no, I'm not. And he starts talking a mile a minute and you get a little confused as to like, wait a minute, what's he saying? And you start thinking maybe there's something to what he's saying, and then you quickly realize there really isn't. And just because of who he is, his name, he had done good in the past with some of the stuff that he did, I believe, with the clean water in New York. He brought some cases in the sort. But it's sad to see how far he's fallen. And then as you know, you start to think, you go, where did he go to this? And you know, he's had a lot of tragedy in his life. Clearly, his father, his uncle, he's lost other people in his life. And I think that there was instability in his life. He had addiction issues a long time ago. I think that that's all come back at this point to bring him to the point where he is. And this lawsuit is just a joke because, again, him saying that this is something that the Biden administration is doing is just cuckoo, because if you look at it, other social media companies were doing it to other people before the Biden administration. They were doing it under the Trump administration. People were getting banned from misinformation, or they were getting tagged for misinformation. I've been tagged for saying something that the algorithm thought was somehow wrong, and they've taken that video off. I didn't turn around and go, well, Instagram is clearly working with the government to get me. But that just sounds like a conspiracy theorist talking about their conspiracy. So in his brain, it's all just twirling and it's all about him. The problem with conspiracy theorists is the whole world is out to get you. But the reality is, no, you're just saying some cuckoo stuff and those videos got to go. And as John said, the fact that we showed a few clips of his, this video might go.
We'll have to see. And when it comes to the lawsuit, it seems like that would be a difficult one to win on, but perhaps we'll see.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air.
So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.